Hey everyone, I'm Aris with Federal Reserve IT Client Services here in Kansas City, and I'm going to walk you around our area and kind of talk about what we do. So first thing to notice about our space is we want it to be kind of inviting because in our name, Client Services, our clients are actually the employees that work with us, and that's primarily who we support. We've got another little section down here where we would do PC deployments and some area for troubleshooting or iPhone deployments. So, what is this job? I would say it's a local IT or desktop support job, kind you'd expect from any organization that dishes out computers to its employees. They got a problem. First, they're going to go to our national service desk or the help desk, and they'll try to get the problem solved. If the help desk can't solve that problem, then they usually engage local IT or desktop support. The local IT jobs may not necessarily require a four-year degree, but usually a lot of experience or a two-year degree and some experience. And they're all going to be fairly similar as far as what they cover. It's the hands-on sort of IT that help desk doesn't do. Local IT, since we are here to help everybody and provide solutions for everyone, we tend to interact with almost every department and almost every person within the organization.
Hi everyone, my name is Joe Ganino and I'm with the IT support division here at the Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City. This is a giant pile of computers, and it's just one of the many fun parts of my job. I am responsible for fixing, maintaining, you know, keeping things secure, all of the different computers we have in the building. This giant pile behind me is the last step in the process. They've got to get wiped and sent on to our surplus vendor, or in some cases donated to the community for use by other folks. There's a wide variety of different opportunities here, but I think the big thing to touch on is that if you like to tinker with computers in your free time, if you are the guy that's fixing or gal that's fixing things for your friends and family, if you're fixing iPhones, if you're helping mom with Windows problems, or you're a Mac person, this is a great career track to look into. Certification-wise, you know, if you want to go down that route, I would suggest looking at the basics are always good. A+, Network Plus, Security Plus, things like that. They're CompTIA certifications. Those are great places to start. Beyond that, position day to day, you know, a lot of the entry level types of positions in IT at the Federal Reserve are going to be related to, you know, help desk or first level call work. An average work day, you know, usually 8 to 5 type hours. You know, we come in, we'll do some troubleshooting on workstations. If you're on the desktop support team, if you're on the help desk, you're going to be in taking calls or chat queue questions from employees, helping them fix their issues. I myself do not have a four-year degree. When I left high school, I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do. And I was actually pressured into going to a four-year university, and it didn't work out well for me. I wasn't ready for that. I just really didn't know what I wanted. And so I ended up just doing the thing that I love the most, which is working with computers. And I was able to get a full-time position, fortunately, right after college as a desktop support person. Now, I'll preface that with, I started working as an actual IT person at 14 in high school, you know, fixing teachers' computers and doing things like that. But it's never really too early to get your start. But after that, you know, I gained some experience there. I did some retail work. I was able to get a contracting gig here at the Federal Reserve in 2011 as a help desk employee. And since then, I've been able to do all kinds of cool things because I have an organization that supports me. And you know, your mileage may vary. Some organizations still like to see at least an associate's, but the equivalent combination of experience is the thing that matters. If you know your stuff and you've got at least a little bit of experience under your belt, you know, a lot of big companies are more than willing to give you that opportunity. Now, at the very basic level, retail positions at like something like a Best Buy, you know, doing computer repair there, even just, you know, being the guy in the department that understands the laptops and helping sell them to people, that's a great way to get in at the very entry level. You also can do first level support for things like, you know, maybe you're answering calls or chats for like Apple. They have that for support purposes, or for a company that you're answering technical support questions via chat. You know, those are usually work from home opportunities or entry level opportunities there. I'd also say, you know, very entry level networking. or telecommunications jobs where maybe you're deploying or handling iPhones or Android phones or desk phones in an office environment. Those are great options too. And they all roll in nicely together. The only other thing I'll mention is that, you know, if problem solving isn't something you enjoy, I would definitely steer away from IT. Problem solving is an integral part.